Hello, I'm Travis Wilson, and I'm here in Midtown St. Charles, Missouri to visit Midtowne Market on Hawthorne Avenue. This locally owned and operated business has been in existence since 1984, and it's been serving generations ever since. So come with me as we check it out. Hello, I'm Travis Wilson, and I'm joined today by Roy Coors here at the Midtowne Market in St. Charles. Roy, thank you so much for joining us today.
You're welcome.
So Roy, this is such a great store that you have here. Can you tell us a little bit about the history of your store and what prompted you to get into the grocery business?
Well, it all started in 66 when I was working for McDonnell Aircraft at the time, and they asked me to join the business. They had opened were in the process of building the store with Hedges and Hoffer on 2700 Rusty. So that's how I got started. My wife was a Hedges, and that kind of prompted them, I think, to ask me to join the business. I don't know, it's hard, kind of hard to say. But they needed some help and some leadership, so that's when I joined that. And then in 1982, I think it was, or 19, yeah, it was 1982, they closed all the Hedges and Hoffer stores, and I took over, myself and three other people took over the one at 2700 Drusty. And we operated it for a year and a half until the first day of 1984 we came over here and started this store running, so that we've been here ever since, so 30 years plus.
30 years, wow, that's amazing. Now, recently, you changed from Midtowne IGA to Midtowne Market. Can you tell us a little bit about what prompted that decision?
Well, we felt that we weren't really doing the customer a service by the products that we were carrying, so we switched to a Midtowne Market, which has a lot more variety, and I felt it was more of what the customer needed versus what we were giving him. We're not really going anywhere, and we needed to step up from where we were. So we made the change, and that's when we had to change the name because we weren't an IGA store anymore. I feel that the IGAs were kind of living in the past, and they're more out of the country than they are in the country. And we needed something different.
So now that you're Midtowne Market, do you feel that it has enabled you to remain competitive as opposed to some of the other grocers that have come and gone here in St. Charles?
Well, it's not been easy, with the Schnucks store opening and Walmart doing their number. So it's affected us, and we think that we can overcome whatever has affected us. We have in the past, and the business is really the business itself is not really very easy. It's something that requires a lot of attention and a lot of, I call it, guts, because you never know what's around the corner. You don't know things change so fast that it really, really becomes very, very difficult to keep up with what's going on.
So, Roy, now that you've switched to Midtowne Market, do you feel that helps you to remain more competitive as opposed to some of the other grocers that are here in St. Charles?
Yeah, I feel it's more competitive. We have more variety than what we had before, and it's a bit of a change for the customer because they don't. They maybe don't know what our brands are, and they really don't, not in this area, but it's known pretty well in the Springfield area, and down by the lake it's pretty well known. So it's always a challenge for you to stay where you are. Sometimes status quo is not too bad.
Very good. Well, Roy, thank you so much for joining us today.
Yeah, you're welcome.
I believe we're also going to talk to your son, Scott Coors, coming up next with us.
Okay.
Now we're going to talk to Scott, who is the president and current manager of Midtowne Market. Scott, thank you so much for joining us.
Absolutely.
Appreciate having you today.
Glad to be here.
So Scott, tell me a little bit about why you decided to open your business here in St. Charles as opposed to any other municipality in the St. Louis area.
Well, our roots run pretty deep here. We've been a part of this community since the 1800s, my great-grandfather. So I don't know that I personally had a choice in opening in St. Charles, but I definitely feel a deep-rooted love for the community and have never really considered taking the business elsewhere. This is where my friends and my family are, and you know, this is where we want to do our thing.
Well, I can completely understand that, and wouldn't you say that your customers really identify with that as well? The people that you've seen come through here really feel that same sort of connection to St. Charles that you're describing. Is that correct?
Right. I can't tell you how many kids I've seen grow up in this store, you know, then come to work here. And, you know, if they come back every summer when in between college and things like that. And it's just a really a good place for, it's a good place to work. It's a good place to grow up. And we just feel like we're such a part of this, not just St. Charles, but this little borough of St. Charles. And, you know, I think it's one of the best kept secrets in St. Charles, and we'd love it if more people knew about it and were able to, you know, share in the experience.
Well, absolutely, and I couldn't agree more. And as a matter of fact, you talked about something a minute ago, talking about the kids specifically. Mm-hmm. That's something that's really close and near and dear to your heart, where you have been a baseball coach, softball coach, is that right?
Something sure. St. Charles Junior Baseball Softball Association. We've been sponsoring their teams for as long as I can remember. And, of course, I've raised three kids in this community and coached all three of them with varying degrees of success. But love to do it. Great bunch of people to work with. And we work with, of course, the churches and the schools and all other types of organizations and try to give back to the community as, you know, just as a part of what we do and who we are. You know, we feel like we take a lot out of the community in terms of people's hard-earned dollars. And so we do try to turn around and give back to the community as much as we can.
Well, that's very admirable. And you mentioned about the hard-earned dollars. That's probably part of the reason why you had decided to make the change from Midtowne IGA to Midtowne Market.
Yes, sir, it sure was. It was not an easy decision. We pored over different possibilities for over a year and ultimately just decided that this format, this warehouse could deliver better value. It has two tiers of private label pricing. One is the best choice, which is kind of the equivalent of the IGA and everybody else's national brand. But then we also have this always safe tier, always the low prices every day. And we really believe like it helps us compete with the box stores and some of the other lower price stores in our community. We can be both of those things to people.
Well, obviously, as you hit upon earlier, the economy has definitely been a factor in how people buy their groceries, how they throw parties. How have you seen that affect the choices that people make when they come in here to do their shopping?
Yeah, we're absolutely sensitive to the economy and what's been going on here the last, what seems like forever, but you know, probably the last five or more years. And we just feel like by giving them more choices, more competitive pricing, that it makes their life easier. One of the things with the old label that we had was very rarely would they have what we call a temporary price reduction.
Okay.
And with the best choice, you'll see it throughout the store every day on, you know, hundreds of items, including the name brands, including the national brands. But, you know, we feel like that makes their life easier and their choices simpler.
Absolutely. And, you know, speaking from a family perspective myself, I completely understand how you would want to make those choices in the most economical way possible.
Yes, sir.
So, Scott, tell me a little bit about what makes Midtowne Market different and unique, mm-hmm. as opposed to some of the other places that people can do their grocery shopping.
Sure. Well, I think what makes us special, without a doubt, is our perimeter departments. So it's the departments that line the store, starting with the bakery. I don't think anybody does donuts better than we do, and I've heard that from a million customers over the years, and of course they do fresh baked breads as well. in the deli. Oh my goodness, they are just amazing. The fried chicken is without rival, and they just do all kinds of special food throughout the week. They have a daily lunch special, and I think the sandwich bar is something also. We fresh bake the bread every day, and I think people see that sandwich bar sometimes and don't realize that you can come up there anytime and pretty much get any sandwich that you want with any meat, any cheese, and it's reasonably priced, and you just get a lot more product for your dollar in our deli than you do the next deli or the next, you know, fast food restaurant. I think we really deliver quality and value in our deli department. One of the other things I think is definitely worth mentioning about our deli is that we have our own line of what we call OVO. It stands for Our Very Own, and it's all of these products and salads that we make right here at store level with fresh ingredients. They're not coming in from a commissary. They're not coming in from another manufacturer. Over 50% of our things in our deli, as far as our salad's concerned, are made right here. And from our chicken salad to our potato salads and just about anything else you can name, and some specialty things that we do during the holidays, made right here. And so the freshness doesn't get any better than that.
That's really amazing, Scott, because you don't find that very much anymore. And that really is a testament to the quality that you're trying to preserve here at Midtown.
Exactly. I think it's another one of the things that makes us unique.
Absolutely.
And then with the meat department and produce, just super high quality, just caring customers. The meat department, we like to call them old school, and they just do a great job. I mean, you just sense a different quality about our meat department, about our employees. I mean, our average meat cutter has been back there probably 20 years.
No kidding.
So they do all the specialty stuff, the crown rib roast, the pork roll. If you don't know about our famous pork roll, get ready to start a new family tradition, because that's the thing you want to have on your dinner table in the holidays. We've been doing it for years.
Amazing.
Yeah.
And I can certainly attest to the donuts. I have tried them myself, and they are awesome.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
I have nothing to do with them other than, you know, overseeing the quality, like yourself, a little quality control from time to time.
That's right. Well, you know, Scott, it's been an absolute pleasure to have you.
Yeah.
And we're looking forward to having Scott's sister, Julie, with us next.
Thanks, Travis.
Thank you, Scott.
You bet.
And now we're joined by Julie, who is also a part of the Coors family. Julie, thank you so much for joining us today. It's a pleasure to have you.
Thank you, Travis.
So, Julie, tell me a little bit about the staff that you employ here and the type of people that have come to work for you over the years.
We employ around 70 people here in our bakery, deli, meat department, produce. Many of our employees have been here for over 25 years.
Wow.
And we have, you know, we hire people in and out all the time, and we have a very low turnover. It's a great place to work. People grew up in this area, and they like to work in this area too. We have a lot of, like I said, longtime employees here that become part of our family too.
Absolutely, and it almost sounds like it's truly a community type of a situation here at Midtown. I would imagine you probably know a lot of your customers from years past.
We do. I grew up in St. Charles, went to school at St. Charles High. I see a lot of the parents of the people that I went to high school with. I will occasionally see, well, I see on a daily basis somebody I did go to school with, and then see people that I haven't seen in a really long time that are perhaps coming back to visit their parents. So it's still a great neighborhood, and just a lot of great families that live in the area.
That's excellent. And because you have seen so much of that repeat business, it was not too long ago that you decided to expand, and that's what we see here. This is
mm-hmm.
your newer area, is that
right,
correct?
That is correct. We added the frozen and the dairy sections. They've been here since, I guess, 08. But we did add the beer cave, that we call it. We have a lot of craft beers. We have a lot of your basic, you know, ones that everybody knows about. We have a wide variety of Missouri wines. and just pride ourselves on having some of the different craft beers or signature beers out there.
I see. And so, just to switch gears on you a little bit, can you tell me, do you have any interesting grocery stories that you can share with us?
Well, there's a lot that I can't share, but there are some. I think the most interesting part of it here is that we see people, we'll see small children come in with their parents or their grandparents, and we see them grow up. And it eventually, sometimes those kids actually start working for us too, because they know us, we know them, we know their families. So that is sort of unique to this grocery store, is that, you know, people come in repeatedly, we get to know them, we kind of know about their lives too. They become part of us, and, you know, we hope that we become part of their everyday life.
Well, I would imagine that is the case, especially since people have been coming to your market to do their Thanksgiving, their
right.
Christmas shopping, their Easter shopping,
right.
That sort of thing. And so not only are you part of them relationship-wise, but you're also a part of feeding their families and
right.
celebrating their special occasions.
Right. And they come to us if they have questions on how to cook a particular slice of meat or just anything. I mean, we will a lot of times, some will go, how do you make this? And I'm like, well, I don't know, but let me go on the computer and I'll pull it up and I'll print you out a recipe. And they are like, oh, that would be great, you know?
Oh, excellent. So, someone was looking to prepare something
mm-hmm,
really special,
mm-hmm.
perhaps for some visiting family members.
Right.
They could come to the store and
yeah.
you could help them to print out, you
mm-hmm.
know, sort of a three-course meal type.
We could possibly do that, yes.
Excellent.
Or even just a particular recipe that they're looking for, they don't know what it is, and we Google it and find out for them.
That's really helpful, because I know myself, there's something that my grandmother used to make. She made a particular type of cookie that, you know, I would probably need to look up on Google, because, you know, it's hard to access those things once somebody's not there anymore, right?
Right, right.
Absolutely. Well, tell us a little bit about how people can get a hold of you, Julie. How can they find your store?
Okay. We have a couple different ways you can do that. You can follow us on Facebook. We have a very active Facebook page. You can also find us on midtownmarket.net, and you have to put the E on Midtown. It's MIDTOWNE market.net. And when you go to our website, you can also sign up for our e-blasts. We send an e-blast every Tuesday that has our ad for that week.
Really?
So they can sit right at home, pull it up on their email and check it out, and then come in and do their shopping.
Excellent. So when people are looking at your ad in your weekly e-blast, does that sometimes include coupons or discounts, ways to save on the groceries?
Yes, there could be coupons involved. The other great part, the website we have now is brand new. So there's lots of recipes on there. You can build your shopping list on there and print it out and bring it with you. It's just got a whole lot of bells and whistles that our other website did not have. So we're real excited about it.
And that's accessible on your iPhone or smartphone as well, correct?
Right, right.
That's really helpful, because obviously people are always looking for ways to save time.
Mm-hmm, right.
Well, Julie, thank you so much for being with us today. I definitely appreciate your time.
Well, thank you.
For Roy and Scott and Julie, I'm Travis Wilson, and this has been Check Out St. Charles. Thanks for watching.